Now here you can see the structure of ovule. Okay, so this is a ovule structure which is present inside the ovary, which is having the main part, that is embryo sac, in which there is a female gamete called as the egg. Okay, so here you can see the many parts. Like, we are going to focus only on the main parts. Like this part is a funicle. So the funicle is a small stalk through which the body of ovule gets attached. Okay, the next is, you can see the pinkish portion, these two layer, which is known as integument. The outer layer is called as the outer integument, while inner layer is known as inner integument. Okay, so the main function of this integument is to protect the inner nucellus. Okay, so they are going to protect the inner part where the nucellus as well as embryo sac is present. Okay, so you can see one more thing here, that this integument is not continue. They has been interrupted through the small channel or the aperture. So this small aperture is known as micropyle, and the micropyle, the main function of the micropyle is they are acting as a channel opening for entering of the pollen tube, so that the pollen tube gets penetrate in this channel and can reach to the this embryo sac, where exactly the egg is present, or I can say where exactly the fertilization process will be done. Okay, now just inner to this integument part, there is a nucellus, and nucellus are actually parenchymatous in nature, and they are also playing very important role for providing the nourishment to developing embryo sac. So here, coming to the main part, that is embryo sac, which is exactly called as female gametophyte. So as they are having the female gamete, so they are called as female gametophyte. They are oval in structure and having multicellular, like they are having many cells. So we can count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So they are 7-celled and 8-nucleated structure, because all the cells are having individual nucleus except one cell, that is secondary nucleus or polar nuclei. So this is having 2 nuclei. So the count of the total nucleus in all these cells are 8. Okay, so this is called as an embryo sac, where exactly the female gamete, like egg, is present, in which the pollen tube will enter and release the 2 male gametes, so that the double fertilization can done. Okay, so here this is a structure of the ovule. Now we are going to focus on how exactly the double fertilization process takes place. Okay, so this this is the part of the gynoecium. Yeah, you can see here. Yes, this is a stigma part, this one is a style, and this is ovary. You can see a stigma, style, and ovary. So this entire structure is of carpel. Okay, so here you can see the small bluish color cell, which is a pollen grain. So as pollen grain is called as male gametophyte, as they are having male gametes, as they fall or attach on the stigma part, like stigma, as I have told you, they are receptor or receiving part. So stigma being a rough, somewhat slight, they are rough, so that the pollen grain can easily untangle on this surface. And even the stigma part, they are having a sugary substance, so that the sugar substance, they gets, you know, absorbed by the pollen grain. So the outer layer of the pollen grain, they gets rupture, and the inner intine, they will get germinated. So this germinated part is called as a pollen tube, which gets penetrate inside the style. Okay, so the style is acting as a channel through which this tube will going to enter and will reach finally to the chamber of the ovary, where exactly the ovule will be present. Okay, so the ovule, as before we saw, that they are having small aperture called as a micropyle. So this micropyle is acting as an open channel through which the pollen tube will going to enter, where exactly they will get interacted with the embryo sac, that is female gametophyte. Okay, so now to the either side of the egg, you can see the pinkish cell, they are called as a synergid. So this synergid is having watery content through one of the synergier, sorry, the pollen tube will enter through one of the synergier. All the water content is absorbed by the pollen tube, through which the pollen tube will burst. And as they get burst, they will release the male gametes or the content in the embryo sac. So as the pollen tube was having two gametes, this is a one gamete, male gamete, and this is the another one. So one of the male gamete will get fused with the egg to form a zygote. So here you can see the male gamete 1 will fuse to form a zygote with a female gamete, and the next male gamete will get fused with the secondary nucleus or the polar nuclei. So as we know that secondary nucleus was already having two nucleus, and one of the nucleus from the male gamete, they get fused to form a triploid one. So here it is called a triploid fusion. Okay, so male gamete 1 will fuse with female gamete to form zygote, and male gamete 2 will fuse with the secondary nucleus to form embryo. Okay, so this is how the double fertilization process takes place. So why exactly we call this process as double fertilization? Because as soon as the pollination takes place, like once the pollen grain, they get fall or get attached to the stigma part, they will germinate, they will form the pollen tube, and once the pollen tube will get enter to the embryo sac, okay, so they will release the two male gametes, and twice the fusion takes place. One fusion is here and next fusion is here. So that means twice the fertilization is taking place. So that's why the process is called as a double fertilization. So here I have given the keywords, just the process, so that easily we can remember. It is a complex process. The fertilization is a complex process in flowering plant, that is angiosperm. So after pollination, the pollen grain will reach on the surface of stigma, where they get germinated, okay, which is called the pollen pistil interaction. So this germinated pollen germinated pollen tube will penetrate in the style channel, so that they can reach to the ovary part, where exactly the ovule is present. In the ovule, there was a small opening called as a micropyle, and this micropyle is acting as a channel through which the pollen tube can reach inside the embryo sac. Okay, so inside the embryo sac, there is a synergid cell. So synergid cell is having watery content, which is absorbed by the pollen tube, so that the pollen tube gets ruptured. And after rupturing or bursting of the pollen tube, all the pollen tube content will release, which is having the pollen, male gametes. So two male gametes will release in the embryo sac part, where double fertilization will takes place. Okay, so this was about the double fertilization.